Now we will discuss about the elastic potential energy stored due to elasticity. About this, we can write: when a solid is elongated by an external force, we can say some work is done. In this process, and a part of this work is stored as potential energy, which we term as elastic potential energy, in the material, due to which restoring forces exist. Or we can say, when a solid is elongated, the restoring forces opposes the elongation, and due to this opposition, the restoring forces are doing negative work, and hence these are absorbing energy, which is stored as potential energy, as elastic potential energy in the material. Like, for an example, say we are having a rod, and the one end of this rod is clamped, it is fixed, and the other end is pulled out with a force F. Say it is of length L, and say we elongate it further by a distance x. In this situation, if the rod is elongated by x, so by the definition of Young's modulus for the rod, we can write: Young's modulus is force upon the cross-sectional area of the rod. Say its cross-sectional area is given as A. This is F upon A divided by the strain in it, will be x upon L. So in this situation, we can directly get the value of x, which can be written as FL upon YA. This is the value of elongation in the rod. Now in this situation, if we just carefully look on this expression, this can be rewritten as F is equal to YA by L into x. It means, if the elongation in the rod is x at equilibrium, the external force required to maintain the elongation is YA by L into x, or this force is directly proportional to x. This is the situation as if the rod is behaving like a spring, having force constant equal to YA by L, so that if it is having an elongation x, then the restoring force on it will be kx. So in this situation, for the rod, we can say equivalent force constant of rod, as if it is behaving like a spring, is this equivalent force constant can be written as YA by L. This is an important concept. Remember it for future. You must keep in mind that rod can be treated like a spring with equivalent force constant YA by L, and if its force constant is taken as YA by L, and if the rod is elongated by a distance x, we can say that it will also store some potential energy. So we can say, at elongation x, the potential energy stored in rod is, this you can be written as half kx square, which we have already studied. That if there is a spring having force constant k is elongated by x, the total potential energy stored by the spring is half kx square. So on substituting the values, we get half k can be written as ya by l multiplied by x. We can write as fl by ya whole square. On simplifying this expression, we will get half F square L by YA. This is the expression for potential energy stored in material of rod. And this we have calculated by its equivalent analogy, like spring. We can also calculate the energy density in the material of rod, as the whole energy stored within its volume only. Let's see this also. In continuation, let us discuss about the density of elastic potential energy in the material. This density can be written as potential energy stored divided by the volume of material. This is expressed by the letter UE, small u, E. And as we have discussed the potential energy in previous case, it is calculated as half of F square, L by YA, divided by total volume of rod is given as AL. It is written as half of F square by A square multiplied by reciprocal of Young's modulus. And as we know, F by A can be written as stress, so this can be written as half of stress in the material square divided by Young's modulus. This is the expression for elastic potential energy density. And we also know that Young's modulus can be written as stress by strain, so this elastic potential energy density can be written as half of the product of stress and respective strain in a material. This expression you must remember, and the units used are joule per meter cube. For calculation or measurement of this elastic potential energy density, either of these relations we can use half of stress by Young's modulus or half of stress multiplied by strain. Either of these can be used for the calculation of elastic potential energy density in numerical applications.